in. Gonna play some Corpse Party. Chapter 4. Let's do it. Yes! Don't be weird. Don't be weird. It's weird. Come on out, you. I'll wash your back. I can wash it myself, you know. We're both children. Yikes! Stranger danger. Snicker. What you hiding under your hands there, little man? There are no secrets in this bathroom. Come on, don't! Yeah, please, just don't. I'm with you. Like, not with. Obviously not with... Mwahaha! Take this and this! What are you doing? Come here, you little cutie pie. He needs an adult! Seriously! Erp, so stop it! Come on! Uh-oh. Gotcha. Not cool. Pant. Jeez, why do you have to be like that? Yeah, I'll say. Teehee. Pant. You know, sis, one day you're gonna end up sleeping the rope fandango. Hmm? Sometimes you really are like a mum. Sorry, mom. You really think so? Giggle. You're such a sweetie. I didn't mean it like that. You've really grown up, you. Always thinking about your big sister's feelings. Oh, hey, Bloodmon! Glad you could make it. Enjoy. Hopefully, let me know if the quality's a bit iffy. I had to restart, but I think I've got it right now. But you're still young, you know. Too young to act like such a grown-up. You should stop worrying about me and keep on being a kid. Hick. Sob. Giggle. Aw, you're crying. See, you really are still just a kid. Whine. Want some of Mama's milk. That's not even possible. Don't be a perv. Worst mum. Worst sister mum ever. You're such a good kid. Don't ever change, okay? I hope you stay like this forever. And I hope that I don't die tragically in a bathroom in a haunted school. Sis is really late getting home today. And she said Dad had a surprise for us too. Said she'd help me get ready for it. I wonder how much longer she'll be. I'm gonna say forever. Oh, that's a bird. Ack. Man, are we having a typhoon or something? Such weird weather. Yeah, I'd be okay with it if they were all adults, but considering these are like 10 to 13 year old children or something, it's a bit on the nose at times, but it is it's a game maker game. Really, as far as quality control goes, there's none. So take it or leave it, I think the fact that it makes you uncomfortable is one of the charming things about the game. If it didn't, it wouldn't be quite as... I want to say creepy, but I also want to say... Just, you should feel uncomfortable playing it, because the themes, while in a way kind of realistic, children are generally the victims, and they're generally the they're the most easily victimized people in existence. It's children and the elderly. So it makes sense that it would happen to them. But Western culture doesn't like talking about it as much. Eastern culture has no problem with it whatsoever. Gotta watch out on those foreshadowing birds. They do have a habit of popping up at just the worst possible times. Especially when talking about someone you love. Who's dead. Like, very dead. Uh-oh. Mayu? Speaking of dead, what is it, Mum? I'm running late. This is your last day at Kisaragi. Make sure you say your goodbyes and have a lot of fun with your friends, okay? I will. There's some foreshadowing dialogue for you. I'm so sorry about this, all because your father got transferred. It's okay, I'll be fine. I wish your father would have objected more strongly. But he said there was nothing he could do about it. And since you didn't object either, I swear, that man doesn't give this family any consideration. All he thinks about is work. Well, I gotta run. Bye! Goodbye forever! I just want my mum and dad to get along. Oh no, I'm playing as Mayu. This cannot end well. Gasp! Huh? Where am I? I don't think it's that Eastern culture doesn't give no shits. I think it's more that Eastern culture is more open to the idea. Yes. Well, you know, there's been some Western games with Hitler in it as well. Why am I by myself? And well, why am I crying? Shig, bro, you there? Miss Yui, Shinazaki, anybody? I was just in the classroom with everybody taking down the festival decorations. God, where even is this? In Terabang. Where? What? No, please. Whimper, whine, wheeze. Stop it, Mayu. Don't succumb to panic. Well, Hitler may have been a pretty cool dude, except for all of the horrible, horrible, terrible, awful things he did. I don't think he wore sunglasses, though. Take a deep breath and try to think of a charm or something to get you through this. Wheeze, wheeze. That's it! Shinazaki's charm, the one we all did, so we'd be friends forever. Wait, it's gone! I can't find it anywhere! My Sachiko Forever paper scrap, gone! Is it because I didn't put it away before the earthquake? I couldn't bear to, but I had it in my hand, I know I did! This sucks! What happened after that? Grumble, my stomach is in bad shape too. I'll tell you what, it's gonna be in worse shape soon. Why does stress always give me indigestion? I thought we got away from the bathroom in the last chapter. In Terabang? Oh good, ghosts. I sure hope
Giggle, ha ha. Ghost voice. Hee hee, ha ha, hee hee hee, ha ha.
Hope there's not too much ghost voice. What were they? They went in that room. Maybe I should have a look. Maybe I should go towards the danger. I'll be fine. Olg. Ooh, my head. Where am I? It's very unlikely that your friends are coming back from this one. Oog. I'm in the main building?
Because it is one dead body, two dead bodies,
I'm in the main building? Wake from a bad dream and find myself in another, damn it! Okay, so let's just save it so we don't have to go through that all over again. It's an old-fashioned space heater. It's still an old-fashioned space heater. Now, I don't believe anything would have changed in here. This is all still the same. Now, you lost your sister, so maybe you should try to go to the other place. Ooh, music is getting tense. I'm so tense right now. Not too sure how to get back there. And if I'm moving a little wonky at the moment, I'm going to kill you. Lovely. To be honest, if I was being chased by the Count who is trying to teach the horrible thing known as maths, I would be pretty scared.
Watch out, I'm going to count at you!
If I'm moving a little wonky, it's just because I'm using the PS4 controller this time. I wanted to try and reduce the amount of noise I made with the keyboard. But now I can't move in a straight line. Ah, oh, good.
Kill, curse, hurt sister hate.
Okay, I get it. You don't like your sister. Okay, the custodians. Is that a television? I did find the video cassette the other building. Satoshi removes the tape from his bag and rereads the label. Kibiki Research Tape, 2005-11-19. It might hold some important information if only we had a way of watching it. Fingers crossed, I guess. Okay, so this chapter I should probably find a key for it, I guess. Don't know if anything else has really changed. Oh, there's a flashy. Oh, if it's a teleporting flashy, this could be a problem. So I'm all on my own. It's a teleporting flashy. Good. With the light jumping back and forth like that, I'll never be able to get the object by myself. Someone else will have to lend me a hand. So I guess I'll have to find someone else. Someone else. Oh, God. Oh, this is, can I? Oh, I can use the D-pad. Okay. Okay. Oh. Okay. It's the body of a high schooler. Whoever it was seemed to have just died minutes. Wow, I just keep paraphrasing. Whoever it is seems to have only died mere hours ago. Minutes or even moments ago. I should just read what's on the screen. Azumaki West Senior Private School, someone, something. There's a yellowed sheet of notebook paper on the floor next to the body. The shakiness in the lettering and the contents of the memorandum suggest that its writer was on the verge of death well before the pen touched paper. I need water so badly, I'm hungry. Sure, but I can deal with that hunger. It's the thirst I can't stand. The other guy I was with, Satoshi Matsubara, he tried drinking that filthy tap water from the sink in the bathroom, but he threw it up almost immediately, and it burnt his chest and his throat so badly that he wound up dying. I've tried to think outside the box, even going so far as to drink my own spit, but needless to say, it didn't help matters one bit. The giveaway, I'll just type this here. Basic. Oh, shoik. I can't. Let me just copy and paste because I unplugged my keyboard. Copy. Paste. Chat. There we go. Okay. So that's the basic information. Pretty much what's going to happen is at the end of every stream, I will give away one key off that list. That list is the same one I was using for the Gleam Steam giveaways. And may go back to as well. The only issue is it's a lot more... It's more that it's more convenient for me to do it like this now. And it's something to, you know, it's something for the folks that stick around. I've tried to think outside the box even to go so far as drinking my own spit, but needless to say, it didn't help matters one bit. My tongue's so swollen at this point that I can't even talk. Ironically, it's been pouring outside since we got here. If only I could have found a way to gather some of the rainwater. Satoshi might still be alive. Well, see, you put your hands like this. It's almost as if someone's playing a cruel joke on me, showing me more water than I've ever seen before, but putting it outside of my reach. Somebody wrote that there's a whole other wing at this school, accessed through an outdoor walkway, but I never found it. As a last resort, I'm going to try drinking my own blood. My name is Hidemasa Kojima. I'm an 11th grader in class 2-4 at Amazaki West High. If anyone reading this ever makes it out of here alive, please tell my family, tell my father, what happened to me. I don't want to be a missing person for the rest of his life. I hate the idea of him always wondering where I went, or even if I'm still alive. It seems to continue, but the rest of it is completely drenched in blood, rendering it totally illegible. Well, he was really thirsty because he caved his own head in to try and drink his blood. Okay. Well, that was unfortunate for him. Oh, yeah, that's right. D-pad. Don't use the stupid analog stick. We're gonna be walking like a drunkard. Oh. I'm pretty sure you're not a new corpse. East Hall. Am I going around in circles? Yes. Great! Oh. Someone seems to have vomited and lost control of their bowels here. Now, previously, this is where we saw... What was her name? I don't remember. We saw her throw up here. Seiko's friend. Big Brother, wah! Yuka! Are you inside of Mayu's corpse pile? The smell of exposed organs permeates the entire hallway. Science lab is still locked. Yes. Mochida, this way! Might not be a ghost. Please, take care of Naomi. Okay, her name was Naomi. She's on the verge of splitting up. Who's there? Who's speaking to me? I could swear that sounded like... a dead person. Who was also one of my friends. Oh, here she is. Naomi! Hey, are you alright? I need you to stand in a room so I can get a glowing thing. Oh, no. She doesn't exist. Naomi! I'm sure that phone is fine. Isn't that Naomi's cell phone? Isn't it ringing? Answer the phone. Yes. Ellipsis. Help me. Blood, I have read through Danganronpa. Help me. And Danganronpa too. I read through them on something awful. Naomi, are you there? And they were fantastic. I'd love to play them if I can find a way. Answer me, please. Naomi, please. Just let me hear your voice. Sob. I think it's the mother again. Please, just say something. I'm your mum, Naomi. God, please, don't let anything happen to her. Hello? Hello! Help me. Help me. Help me. Ooh-ah! What the hell? This place needs to cut the crap already. I mean, there's dead friends and there's ghosts, but just cut it out. I can't just leave it, though. Acquired Naomi's cell phone. Nope, oh, that's something but nothing. My headcanon, even though the actual story of this that takes place after Danganronpa is this a speak. Well, that's mixing some games there. Actually, the death count in Danganronpa is probably higher than it is in this, and that's saying something. A lot of kids die here. But pretty much everyone dies in Danganronpa. Spoilers. Well, it was tough, you know. Okay, well, let's go investigate the talking. Hey, Abby, thanks for coming. I certainly was surprised, So, Seiko, did you hear? What is it? Kishinuma bumped into Satoshi turning around earlier and totally touched his crotch. Wah! Seriously? Ha ha ha! I like it! I like it! When I saw it happen, though, I just wanted to smack Kishinuma upside the head! Bwahahaha! Oh dear, Naomi, do I detect a hint of jealousy? Maybe, maybe not. All I know is right afterward the two of them got into a huge fight. Gahahaha! That's priceless! I wish I could have seen it! I don't think you'd be so keen on it if you were there. It wasn't a pretty sight. I don't know. I have a feeling that I would have enjoyed it anyway. Prepare for some creeps. Oh, they're on Steam. I'll definitely have to pick them up. I don't know if I'll play them next. I might separate this with maybe a dating simulator, and then I'll probably move on to Danganronpa 1. I have a feeling I would have enjoyed it anyway. Chuckle. Boys are such idiots. Cute, though. Aren't boys so cute? Neh, Mochida in particular, right, Naomi? Is someone there? I'll wait until I hear my name mentioned. The door is shut and locked. There is no identification that anyone's inside. Hello? Yeah, I saw one on Steam lately that lets you date like a pot-bellied pig or something. I might pick that one up because it seems ridiculous. Oh! Oh, oh. Interrobang? You sense a presence behind the stall door. Let me in. Gong hung erk alk. Interrobang? Kick in the door! Like an action hero. Naomi! Dumbass! What the hell do you think you're doing? Like a tank dating sim where the girls are named after tank models. Yeah, there's that one too. Naomi! Try to hold her up. I need something to loosen the rope around her neck. Hoist her up on your shoulders. Because I'm a man! Hold on! Urgh! Gasp pant! Good, she's breathing. Naomi, stay with me! I'm going to loosen that rope. Stand on the bucket. Maybe I can get more leverage if I stand on this bucket. Okay, now I've got some leverage. Ack! Uh-oh. Gorg! Oof. Ah, Naomi! Naomi! Did I just kill her? Whatever was in that bucket, it must have been pretty damned corrosive. The bottom gave way under the combined weight of me and Naomi, just as I was starting to lift her to safety. We both came crashing down, but I'm the only one who made it all the way to the floor. Naomi was dropped back into her noose with such force that it instantly snapped her brittle neck. The tiny spark of life she had left in her was suddenly and unceremoniously extinguished. And it's my fault. I killed her with my own bare hands. And she soiled herself. Ooh-ah! Gasp. A good friend who's been smiling and laughing with me in the classroom only a few hours earlier was now dead, dangling limply from the ceiling in a dismal, dingy bathroom stall. Please tell me this is a bad end. The mere fact that this had actually occurred was more frightening to me than any ghost. When I finally came back to my senses, I found myself running as if my life depended on it. I think I just wanted to get out of there, to get away from her body. To free myself from the crushing presence of death. I really think I just wanted to pretend like it never happened. That it's all a dream, it can't be real, I just killed somebody. But my compromised mental state couldn't hold me back for long. I knew I had to face her again. So I went back to the toilet. The way you sound her name when you first opened the door sounded like a comedy show. Like she stole a cookie or something. Aww. Naomi, Naomi, I'm so sorry. I couldn't save you. It's my fault. What do I do now? Sob. I mean, my sister's still alive, but what do I do now? Oh! Hi! Shinohara, not you too! Damn it, why? Why would you do this? Why? Why did it have to come to this? God damn it all.
two hanging bodies! Ah! I am the count and I love to count!
Can I hang myself in this one? No. How about this one? No. Damn it. Her eyes are open but empty. There's no trace of life left. I don't know if I'm satisfied with this. I'm not sure. I think I need a bad end. Big brother. How could that not be a bad end? Yuka. Damn it, I completely forgotten. I'd left her all by herself. I told you so. She went outside to pee in the woods by the outdoor walkway. Wait for me, Yuka. I'm coming. I've had enough loss for one day. If I were to lose you too. Yeah, screw that. Menu. There we are. I'm not taking that. No. There has been enough people hanging in a toilet. I am not having the structural integrity of a bucket dictate how this game's going. Buckets are stronger than that. Okay. Note to self, don't stand on bucket. Bucket bad. At least it doesn't take very long to get back there. But I need someone so I can pick up the glowy. If she ends up hanging, well, I can't use her to pick something up. Now, can I? I went into the wrong bathroom. Well, it's good that this is the first time I came here. What could be in this bathroom? Is it someone talking with surprising clarity even though they're hanging from a rope? No, it could never be. Okay, she was standing on the bucket. So that was the sound of the bucket falling over. I'm an idiot. Kick in the door, Action Man. Try to hold her up. Hoist her up on your shoulders. Reach behind. Give her a reach around and save her life. Ugh, I can't see what I'm doing. Is this it? While still supporting Naomi on his shoulders with her upper body drooping between the back wall of the bathroom and his head, Satoshi reached behind him and fiddled with the knots at the base of the noose. Somehow or another, he managed to loosen the rope's grip. Against all odds, it seems that Naomi would live. Yay! Naomi, hey! You're all right now! Breathe! Pant wheeze! Pant wheeze. Thank you. Okay. Cough. Choke wheeze. Clear her airways, you nubbin. That's it. Easy now. Just like that. Breathe in and out. Slow and steady. Yes, I don't think you need to tell how to breathe. Satoshi? Yeah, it's me. Are you alright? You really had me scared there for a minute. Weep. Sob. Yes, the reach around of life. It's a very important medical procedure. Everybody should learn it. Go take a first aid class today. What? What's wrong? Are you in pain? Dumbass! Hick! Get here sooner next time! Then maybe my friend wouldn't be dead. Sob. Weep moan. Hick. What's... Ah! Sorry! What's wrong with me? What am I doing? No need to apologize. There's no need. Huh? No need to apologize. Ellipsis. Is your neck okay? My neck? What was I doing anyway? I fell down the stairs and then, when I came to, you were here. You don't remember anything? I guess not. After I fell, I heard a snap in my leg and I'd figured I'd broken it. But it turned out it was just the splint that Seiko had used on my sprained ankle earlier. You probably shouldn't have mentioned Seiko. You're gonna start crying now. Shinohara? I think I heard her voice just a moment ago. Any idea where she went? Ooh, shouldn't have said that. Seiko. Seiko is... Hmm? I wonder if the reach around of life would work on her. She's been hanging for a while. That's impossible. I heard her voice. She spoke to me just a few minutes ago. Seiko! Seiko! Sob. Let's get her down. I'd feel bad leaving her like this. In her soiled dress. Doing the rope fandango. We had a fight just before we parted ways. I was the one in the wrong, but I was too stubborn to admit it. And the next time I saw her, Seiko was already dead. It was because of me. She did it over me. Because I said such horrible things to her. She! And I can't even apologize anymore. Oh, yes again, she's right there. Say I'm sorry. Naomi, it's alright. It's not your fault. You do realize that? You also tried to hang yourself, right? I did? That's... It's not true! It's impossible! Search your feelings, you know it to be true. But there is a stinging pain around my entire neck. Did I really? Yeah. So you don't remember. Ellipsis. I'm sure it was the same for Shinohara. I don't think she knew what she was doing. No matter how upset she was, she would never. She wasn't the type to give up on anything, much less kill herself over it. You're right. She wouldn't do that.
Probably not anyway.
Actually, there was a spirit who came to talk to me. A girl about the same age as us. She said that anyone who's been touched by the curse of this school will have their mind taken over and go crazy.
Eerie music. Their mind taken over?
Curse or no curse? I do get the feeling that anyone trapped in here for a long time would go insane. Clearly, we need to get out of this school as soon as we possibly can. The longer we're here, the more danger we're in.
Oh, I'm full of burps. Excuse me.
Oop, I threw up. Never mind. If even Naomi or Shinohara, two of the strongest people I know, can wind up like this, then any of us could be next, myself included. We'd better make sure nobody's left by themselves in here anymore. Like my sister, perhaps. It sounds like we need to hurry and find the others, then get out of here.
Oh no, is this going to turn into some sort of Doctor Who episode where the count... If you get drained by the count, you start counting. It's like, it's like the Stone Angels episode. Instead of counting backwards from 10, counting up from 1.
Yeah, that brings up something else though. That girl spirit also said that this school was on its own version of closed space. And that Seiko and I were the only living beings present. So how did you get here, Satoshi?
One!
Now that you mention it, there's a different feeling in the air now than there was before.
Oh boy, here we go.
Such concern for your friends, and all the impulses that go with it, spurring the heart into action, that's a truly noble sentiment. Now go! Go to the one who occupies your thoughts!
Apparently it wasn't his sister.
Though you probably won't make it!
Come to think of it, I was also approached by the spirit of a high school girl. Shortly afterward, I lost consciousness and woke up not far from here. I wonder who she was. I'm not sure, but it sounds like you somehow made the leap from one closed space to another. It's like the quantum leap. Closed space. The first ghost we saw said that if two people were in different spaces, it would be nearly impossible for them to meet. Ah!
Well, the episode of Doctor Who is trapped on this crystal planet and starts copying that woman. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the crystal entity that they ended up switching minds. That was a good one. And then they were saved by the train stewardess by jumping out of a door. Yay! Way to science that one, Dr. Magician Hood.
Huh? It's nothing. Satoshi? I think I heard Yuka's voice on the second floor earlier. Oh yeah, my sister! Now I remember! You did? The two of us got separated when I lost consciousness, and I stopped thinking about her. She can't be by herself in a place like this. She'll never make it. Last I saw her, she was heading onto the walkway between the two wings. To urinate! Come on, Naomi. This way. Let's get away from the freaking toilet finally, please. Oh, okay. Also, there was a shiny in a room, and I kind of need you. Shinohara, I'm sorry. I wish I could take you with us, but it doesn't seem like that's possible anymore. So here, let me take your piece of paper. Please, forgive me. Take her charm! Sob, Seiko. It could be worse, blood. Ack! Are you okay? Sputter-cough-cough. The damage to her neck and throat may have been worse than I'd assumed. It might have cut off oxygen to her brain or something. Sorry, I suddenly got really dizzy and tripped over my own feet. And now everything's turning white. Yes it is. Naomi! Looks like she's lost consciousness. I need to take her somewhere to rest. Wasn't there a nurse's office or something around here? Where she was abandoned and almost gotten killed by a hair monster? Let's take her there.
Ellipsis. Her breathing seems normal. I guess she's okay.
I need to go find Yuka. Naomi, you stay here and rest up. I know it's dangerous for either of us to be by ourselves. But that goes for my little sister too. I can't just ignore her. I'll be back real soon, I swear.
Okay. I see a slight problem with this, is that she was abandoned in this room earlier, and that didn't go very well. For her, at least. Seiko got to have a nice rope nap. Okay, I still can't... Okay, I need to find the wing. Where the hell was that wing again? I wish I hadn't left so long between play. The walkway's right at the bottom of these stairs to the right. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Exposition Satoshi. Uh-oh. Dumb. It's not here. That's the first time he's looking slightly perturbed. Why? Why is there a wall here? There was a whole other building! What the hell is going on? Yuka! Yuka! It's like the Harry Potter building, it just keeps rearranging. Kulg! Why must you torment me like this? Am I suddenly Yuka? If I am, can I please have urinated already? Kizami! Oh no. The sign said elementary school students couldn't buy them without a parent's permission. But they sold me a hamster anyway. It was only 540 yen. Didn't I tell you? Their lives aren't worth much at all. What? Oh, nothing. So what are we going to do with it? Look how cute he is. I want to take care of him.
Kazami wants to eat him. You kidding, right? That smelly thing? Huh? So what then? Something really special. Wait till you see it. It's like nothing else. The end of a life. The very moment of death. Come on, give it here. This box cutter should do the trick. Stab! What? Are you stupid? Why would you do that? I spent $5 on it! Watch closely now. Yuya, what do you think you're doing? Eep! It's Kazami's sister! Nothing. Stabbing. Don't you nothing me, you little asshole! You've got a knife and an animal in your hands! Yeah, but I didn't do anything yet. So I'm not wrong when I say nothing now, am I? Stupid bitch. Are you for real? You realize that no one likes a smart ass, right? You'd better cool that sass mouth of yours or grow up to be even more of a good-for-nothing dirtbag than you already are. Kazami, give it here. I'll take care of the little guy myself, okay? See you tomorrow. Squeak, squeak. I swear, I don't know how he can put up with you. Just shut the fuck up already. Why did I have to be the youngest anyway? If I had a little brother of my own, I'd love the shit out of him. I sure as hell wouldn't be like my goddamn holier-than-thou sister or my fucking retard of a brother. I'd listen to the little tyke and respect him. And if I had a little sister of my own... Kazami, yeah. Yeah! Please tell me you at least use the bathroom. Hick, hick, shudder. Look. People who end up as serial killers usually harm animals when they're children. That scene just says Kazami has totally been screwed up ever since forever's. So, you know, now he's in a slaughterhouse, effectively. What's the matter, Yuka? They're all full. Oh, just use the bathroom already. I don't want two chapters about using the toilet. Oh! What the hell? Who did this? Or did they do it themselves? The body inside is too near the stall. Every time you try to open it, it just slams into the corpse and bounces off. That's quite a stench. I mean, that's quite a stench. The body inside is too, etc. Okay, I think all the bodies are probably going to be... There's a student ID tag on the floor inside. Shibogami Private Senior High School student Mari someone. The body inside is too... Okay, all of the bodies are too close. There's a student ID name tag. Kotoe Kuroyama. Okay, so, well... Fair enough then! Okay! I guess I understand what they're saying when it's all full. A great many lives ended in this room. Ha! Well. He's a charming individual. I like him! Hya! Wheeze. I'm a great character. Poor little Yuka. With all those bodies in there, you'll never be able to relieve yourself. Shiver. Well then. Shall we be off? My dear
little sister. Sure is cold. Where did Miss Shishido and Kishinuma go anyway? Kishinuma's in a hole. Miss Yui was underneath a cabinet. Don't leave me by myself. I'm scared, you know. Maybe I should try going back to room 1A. If I stay in this other school building for too long, my head's really going to start pounding. Did he karate kick the wall or something? I don't believe so. I think he just had a nice old laugh. Giggle. Oh no, more ghosts. In Terrabang? Uh-oh! It's Lady in Red! She is the worst ghost. No! No more! Red dress? Yes, it was a red dress. Her photo was in that article, so I guess she's one of the victims. Although we found out that she's not one of the victims. Treat tomorrow like a certainty. If you're alive now, trust that you'll be alive then. If I recall, it's Tachibana's turn for day duty tomorrow. I want to go back to class. I hate the idea that I might not even be able to... Whatever. I keep editing the text in my brain. I swear I'll take my schoolwork more seriously from now on. Was this you? Judging by the size, these appears to be the remains of his junior Zor. Junior high school student. I can talk, I promise! It was Seiko Tanaka, actually. It's always difficult to go from English to Japanese to English. The brain has problems processing it. Did she sit in something? Why has she got red on the back of her? Oh yes. I can't go this way. I can't bring myself to see Suzumoto like that again. I feel like I'll lose my mind. Well, I'll lose my lunch. Oh, here's the doll that didn't work. The antique doll you threw down earlier is still lying here. Pick it up? Yes. I believe that will be important. Acquired antique doll. There's a torn piece of newspaper on the ground. It looks like the top part of an article. Let's not read it until we save. Oh. Hmm? What's my candle doing here? I'm sure I left it outside in the hallway. Did somebody move it? No confidence whatsoever. Here we are. Yeah, let's read it. Tenjin Public Relations, the light and dark sides of Heavenly Host Elementary's principal, Takamine Yanagihori. The ground was broken from Tenjin's municipal Heavenly Host Elementary School building in 1952. It quickly became a source of pride for the town, as no elementary school had stood within Tenjin's borders at all prior to its construction. Primary schoolers had previously been commuting to neighboring towns for class, so for them in particular, Heavenly Host is truly a godsend. The coveted position of principal for this new learning institution was awarded to a man named Takamine Yanagihori. Damn it, every time! Yanagihori quickly became popular among the locals for his charismatic personality, his work ethic, and his firm but fair school policies. Registration and attendance soared well beyond the school's capacity, necessitating frequent desk and chair reorders, and even general building expansions. Essentially, due to Yanagihori's unwavering dedication, Heavenly Host became a cornerstone of life within the humble town of Tenjin. But all that began to change on the dawn of one fateful day, with an incident that would set the stage for Heavenly Host's rapid fall from grace. Lines! The newspaper is torn at this point. The bottom half of the article is missing. This book looks different. Hey Dave, welcome to the... Hey, you can moderate, Dave. Do all of the moderating of nothing.
That's cool. Thanks for coming, Dave. Hope you enjoy. There's a blood-spattered notebook on the desk with the word diary written on it. Looks like some sort of prop. I thought the book changed colour. I don't think it was black before. Well, if I'm not allowed to go this way, how am I supposed to get back to the classroom? Is there some other way? Maybe I can go around, I can circumvent it. Weep! Weep! Where is that coming from? Sounds muffled, like those toy Mika doll telephones, but it's definitely close. Gasp! It's damned doll! It's making noises again! I'm not sure why that would be. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. Hold on a sec. Just check my microphone. I don't think I've done any balancing or anything. Two channels. That's odd. No, I'm not sure why I would be doing that, Dave. I'll just have a quick check. No, well, if that's the case, I'm not sure what's going on. I might have to look at the hardware afterwards. Weep, weep! It does seem strange. It might be my mic. That would be a shame. I don't really have the I guess I have the cash to replace it, but I'd rather not.
Whether you're facing a fly on the wall or just standing in the middle of a room, if you think there's something nearby, press the examine key.
Actually, the audio seems to be maxing out. Maybe if I reduce my mic audio. Tell me if that makes any difference.
Never give up!
Oh boy. Giggle! There's an old crumpled up piece of paper next to the body. Well, Yuma, guess this is as far as you go. Exhaustion is set in, so it looks like it's the end of the road. My classmate Tomoe Mizuki climbed the fence around the outdoor walkway and slipped into the woods outside of the school. It's been 3 days now and she still hasn't come back. All the while, I've been stuck here getting chased around by the ghost of a girl with nothing above her jawline. And I've not only twisted my ankle, but also got glass all over my wrists, so I'm in no condition to keep running. I keep hearing this snip 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 sound of scissors everywhere I go. I can't tell if it's real, or if it's just the ringing in my ears. I wish I'd just die already, get it over with so I can finally rest. Maybe I can have my head cut off at the jaw like that lit. Tomoe Mizuki. Whoever this seems to be, only just died mere hours, minutes, or even moments ago, and they appear to be missing their head. Yeah, I'm not sure why it would be going in monooral. It might be the microphone. If it's the microphone, I might have to look at replacing it, which is a shame because they don't grow on trees. I'm not made of microphones. It hurts so much. Even in death, it still hurts. I'm not doing the voice for you because I've already talked to you previously. The fallen cabinet is blocking your path. It seems extraordinarily heavy, but there's glass everywhere. Climbing over would probably be a bad idea. It's probably some balance setting. Well, yeah, I would have thought so. Unless it's because I'm not talking at it straight. But I wouldn't have thought that would change anything. Wonder where a setting for that would be. If you can think of anything, Dave, let me know. I'll have a look into it after the stream, but for now, it's probably best not to just break the flow. Excuse me? I don't like the fact that that hint was there because it might suggest... Custodian's closet, the door is still locked, okay. A
So being made of microphones would be rather inconvenient. It says click on everything. Let me through. Let me through. I wonder if there's another board. I haven't had a prompt that I needed a board. Maybe if she wasn't so squeamish, I could just go the other way and there wouldn't be a problem. Maybe she'd harden up. Congratulations on your arrival. Our most heartfelt blessings we offer to thee. We'll be anxiously awaiting your death. And once everyone's dead, that's when we'll be able to meet again. And then the conquest begins. Congratulations. Congratulations. Oh, hi. It's the body of a middle schooler. Whoever it is seems to have died recently. Yoshige Mibana. Save point. It's curious. It does sound like a setting, but I'm not sure if there's a setting to change the balance on the microphone anywhere. And I certainly wouldn't have changed it myself. Curiouser and curiouser. There's a crumpled up note on the floor. There's one thing I've learnt from all of this. The children are victims too. They're not at fault here. They're not the ones we should hate. Their murderer is the one who created this cycle of resentment and cruelty. Their murderer is our true enemy. Well, no duh. Can't go through this way. Although, that being said, while they might not be our enemies, they are still butchering everybody, so... The message you wrote previously is still clearly visible on the teacher's desk. No one's responded yet. I wonder if everyone's even seen it. My message. Is this still the same? Yes. Oh boy. I'm so glad we could find each other before we died. We'll set off on this journey together, holding hands forevermore. There's nothing to be scared of as long as we are with each other. We know there was meaning to our lives because we were fortunate enough to find our soulmates, to find one another among all the fish in the sea. To our mothers and our fathers, take heart. We died happy and we wanted for nothing. And when we finally pass over to the other side, our hunger pains will be gone. We'll fly up to heaven and be joyous forevermore. Our only regret is the pain our deaths will cause you, but one day we'll meet again up in the golden realm of the forever after. Lexern Senior High School, Hotaru Kanazaki and Nayuki Minatogawa. Probably not. There's a sheet of haphazardly torn paper on the wall. It reads as follows. Idiots, there's no getting to heaven from here. That's just rude. There are two corpses here, both large enough to deduct they were probably high schoolers. It appears they died hand in hand, and their bleached white bones are still holding hands even now. Even though there's no tendons or sinew or skin to allow that to happen. Okay. Oh. There does seem to be space for it to go down one more notch, but this mechanism is locked. There's a tiny peculiarly shaped keyhole in its base. Hey, Bullet Clue, welcome to the stream and my flubbing lines constantly. Enjoy your stay in this horrible, horrible corpse party. Oh, exclamation mark. Oh dear. Ow! Something bad happens. Ayumi's hands landed squarely in the middle of a sea of broken glass from a fallen light fixture. The skin between the index finger and thumb of her right hand was cut wide open. I looked at my left hand. Ooh, ow, 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 it's bleeding pretty badly. I hope the handkerchief can stop it. I've seen the anime. Yes, the anime took one of the stories, one of the possible endings. This follows many. The manga took another one. There's a lot of different ways this plays out. Just found out I'm anemic yesterday, too. Great timing.
Starting to get dizzy now, not good. I need to sit or something. Thank you, Bullet Clue, for the sub. Welcome to the droid army. Slightly cooler than the Star Wars one. Hope you enjoy. And I always say sub, I've got to try and remember. It's a follow. I'm not getting money from you. And that's fine by me. It's like, oh dear, I just found out I'm anemic. Time to get cut. Unbelievable. Alright, so I need to find a key. Oh, never mind. I can't go this way. I'm being gated. It's not like you're going to be rescued after all. We already tried everything we could to get out. We exhausted every possibility. You might live another few days, maybe even a week or two, if you tough it out. But can you stand to live that long with nothing to eat? Nothing to drink? No change of clothes? Dying is just a whole lot easier. So come on, join us. We're all waiting for you. Hey JX! Yes, I am playing. I do enjoy these kind of games, so I will come back. I might find another iteration of it to play later as well, but I'll do that further down the track. It might even be fun. There are so many ways to die. Just imagine the possibilities. But don't tarry. We're waiting after all. Waiting to welcome you. Gorg. Grang. Shut up. Oh, hi, ghosty. Naho, Sayonoki. Oh no, here comes the voice again. Ellipsis. You're a liar, liar, liar! Those child spirits didn't give a crap about the killer's stupid repentance. Give me back Suzumoto, hick sob. Drawer opened? Oh, there he is. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Your voice really travels. Ah, Kishinuma. Well, that was easy. Urk. You okay, Shinazaki? You're the one to ask. What on earth happened to you? There's blood everywhere. Well, soon as you turned that corner before, I got struck in the noggin by some big dude with a giant hammer. I'm fine though, don't worry. Don't know exactly where, but I was locked up in some gloomy little room. And at some point, the chains binding my legs together got loosened. Not sure how, but the second I noticed, I just bolted. Do you know where you were? Not really. It's all kind of hazy. I think I passed out again after a while. And when I came to, I was in the first floor hallway. Not a clue how I got there. So, did somebody carry you? Either way, I'm just glad you're all right. I don't know how much more of this I can take. I don't want anyone else to die. Well, okay. Yeah. It's like, what can you say to that?
I am not mistaken.
Damn ghost voice.
If each of those child spirits were to find peace, even if they had to be appeased one by one, then the closed spaces given shape by their bound souls should not be able to remain in existence.
I set a precedent. I have to keep doing it, unfortunately. We let them hear the killer's regrets, though. And it did not help us. That was quick.
The man with the hammer who attacked you, he was their murderer.
You serious?
It seems he's got a violent streak, even in death. He harms the living indiscriminately.
So your first order of business... Oh, damn it!
...should be to quell his wanton behavior.
And how are we supposed to do that?
Based on my mentor's research, that antique doll you've got in your hands should be a good place to start. Blair. It belonged to him in life. He was given it by his mother, and reportedly he relies on it to keep his mind leveled and his heart in balance. I'm certain he must be looking for it.
Hold on a second. Who's this mentor of yours?
My personal affairs are none of your concern!
Fair enough. Okay, settle down. Settle, kettle. Gasp! What's happening? Oh, there's some more glass.
Sorry about that. You'll need to find that man's body, or his remains at any rate. They should be in the school building somewhere, and if you find them and return the doll to their side, everything will be just fine. Go,
Fair enough. Miss Sayonoki?
Ellipsis!
Oh, she's dead. Again. What the hell was that all about? Can we really believe a word she just said? Maybe not, but it's a good place to start as any. But he's still on the screen, so apparently he's talking to himself. Earlier, as I was passing through the first floor, the doll started crying, like, weeping, loudly. Seriously? Let me tell you, I sure didn't miss having that thing around, for all of the 5 seconds we did. Well, we might just be able to use it like a tracking device. It could lead us right to the murderer's body. Either way, let's just keep moving, okay? Or can you? How's your head? Wow, that's quite a bump you've got. Eh? Guy was a lousy aim, but he still hit my head full force with a handle. If he'd been more accurate, I'd be a goner for sure. Damned child killer. Yeah, damned child killer! You're lucky I just so happen to have some cloth bandages with me. I'll see what I can do about dressing that wound. Part of your prop closet, I take it. Guess I should be thankful for your horror obsession after all. Actually, no, we all wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you. Ah, save point. My favorite. Any new information? No, I believe I've already read that one. Oh, there's a lot of blood by this. The shelf is crammed full of very old, thoroughly yellowed books with unusual titles. One of the books sticking out farther than the others, begging to be perused. Circumnavigating the Ancient World. Read it? Yeah. The cardinal directions are to be laid flat upon a clock face, with additional divisions placed amongst them to mimic the fully times 12 notches. Beginning with the rat affixed at due north, the 12 signs of the Chinese zodiac shall be labeled clockwise around the timepiece compass. Rat, ox, tiger, rabbit, dragon, snake, horse, ram, monkey, rooster, dog, pig, and then back to rat. For ease of remembrance, it's best to equate each direction with both its zodiac sign and its hour on the clock. North, then, is both the rat and 12 o'clock. Scintillating, east is rabbit, and east by southeast is the dragon. This is the basis of circumnavigating within the ancient world. I'm not sure that might come into play? Maybe? I won't remember any of it, but I'm sure it's important. Ah, such a relaxing play, and it's nice to have, for finally, in a chapter, play as a multitude of characters. Okay, so nothing new is there yet. Oh, okay, I can't get through that part of the room. I remember all of this. It certainly has been an experience. Nothing new, no glowings. I do remember a glowy thing, but I can't recall exactly where it was. I know there was one. In one of the rooms, but I'm sure at the moment I have to use my doll tracking device. Weep, weep, from the red door, 6 steps horse, 13 paces rooster. I don't suppose anybody remembers that thing we just read? From the red door, 6 steps in one direction, 13 steps in another. I'm sure there's only a finite amount of directions we can go, so maybe we should brute force it. Giggle! Oh dear, please. No more ghosts. No more ghosty goos. The red door was over here.
Now, okay. Do you think this is considered the red door? Probably not. I mean, it seems to be the red door, but I can't take six steps in any direction. I could be wrong. There might be another red door around somewhere. Too heavy for you. And it's supposed to be on this floor, right? Curiouser and curiouser. Let's not go that way. The air is really heavy. It makes my ears ring. Can't believe there's a second wing to this place. I had no idea. I mean, surely I could only take steps in cardinal directions. But that appears to be the only door, and I can't take six steps in any cardinal direction from there. So I really don't want to have to get a piece of paper. Like... Never mind. One of the floorboards here is slightly raised. Peering through the crack, you can just barely make out some sort of bag in the dark recesses below. Try to pull it out. Yes, please. It's like, never mind. I solved it. Shuffle. With a bit of fidgeting, you were able to remove the item from its compartment. It's a small bag made of hemp and stained liberally with blood. There's a name tag attached to the front. Heavenly Host Elementary School, Class 35, Ryo Yoshizawa. What's going on? What's going to be inside here, I wonder? Here, take a look. Bet it's not a tongue. No way! I'm not touching that thing. You look. Yeah, okay. Ugh, I have a bad feeling about this. Ooh-ah! What is it? What's in the bag? What's in the box? See for yourself. Oh, that's a dick move. Eek! The bag appears to contain a severed human tongue. Weep, weep. Return. Return it. This name tag, it's a boy's name. It must be the ghost of the little boy, Gasp Pant. Cough hack choke. Shinazaki! Pant pant! What do we do with it? Ugh, it's so nasty. It's always with the seven jokes, it's too memorable. You can't not do it. We give it back to its rightful owner. Huh? You out of your mind? Acquired Ryu's tongue. I don't know where his body is. Return it to his body. Okay. Where? Easier said than done. Now, as far as I know, all of the bodies were in the basement. But so far, I haven't been able to get to the basement. But maybe the bodies were moved. And why are the bodies still here? They found them murdered. Surely the police took the bodies with them. Why would they have been left here? This is all very confusing. Oh, no, not that way. Never mind. Help. Time to play the wandering game. I know how much everybody loves just walking mindlessly around till they find something. Yes, please.
I wouldn't exactly call it a puzzle. Unless we were supposed to have remembered where his body was. I don't recall seeing that name tag. And it certainly has to be the tongue of one of the kids that he killed. So I would have thought it was in the basement. Maybe. In any event, while we wait, we can just enjoy the creepy music. Are you going to be of any help? Nope. Okay. You'd think by now there'd be a map. You'd have some spatial awareness of where everything was without any problems, and you just go, bang, I know where that is. It's not clicking. I'd love to help you, small child. I just can't remember my way. Am I okay to go this way now? I can't go this way. Great. Okay. I know what you mean. God damn it, why did she have to die like that? Well, because she was trying to be helpful. Helpful people die. That's pretty apt so far. Helpful people have died. It reminds me a little of The Exorcist, just the piano sting. I guess that's kind of what they were going for. Nope, nope. And back to the music. As soon as we get anywhere of note, the music stops. So I guess hearing the music is a bad thing. Giggle. I always get a giggle right here. Who's giggling? Stop laughing at me! It's not my fault I'm stupid. Well, okay, maybe it is. Let's not pull any punches. I haven't picked up any keys or anything, have I? Just Ryu's tongue and my cursed doll. Okay. The basement is where I think it is. It should be on the first floor. So let's go back to the first floor. Ignore that giggle. This is getting me nowhere. There was a note that said pretty much click everything, which doesn't help at all. The doll is very taciturn right now. It's stoic, if I had to choose a word. That doesn't really want to help. I can't seem to get down to the first floor. I would give you tips to go, but I can't remember. Yeah. It certainly wasn't the two people in love. That requires a key that I don't have. It's very difficult to write a walkthrough for this. Because of all of the different paths. Now please, please, is this upstairs or downstairs? Regardless, I can't go this way. Doesn't want to be nice, not playing nice. Gonna help. No. That's no different. Have I rubbed everything? Have I fondled every possible item? Is there a new message on here? No. Wait, this article, hold on.
No. Okay, I thought there was an article that told me what happened. Maybe there was. Wrecking my brain, but... When it does this, when there's a very finite amount of places you can go... Then it all sort of slows down, because surely it just means I haven't rubbed one thing. And as soon as I grasp it, as soon as I touch it, as soon as I give you the old 1-2, it'll be fine. Until then, you sort of walk around scratching your head. And you just tell me to touch everything. It's almost condescending at this point. Say, you know what you should do? You should go and click everything. I believe it's not in a classroom. I think I remember that much. Yeah. When you die in this accursed place, you experience, yes, your pain. I understand that. I mean, the only thing that's actually happening is I'm getting a giggle here, so whether... It's like, does that mean the body's around here? Not going to be buried under more floorboards, is it? Now I'm just wandering around like a nubbin. It's not an adventure game. I shouldn't just have to click everything until something happens. It's just a lot of dead ends. That's the room to the basement. But I don't think I can get there. The only path. What am I missing? It must just be one thing that I haven't done. Oh, through the floor here had clearly collapsed previously. The gap seems to have mysteriously closed up on its own. Oh, okay. That's awesome. I remember, do you want a hint? Well, if it's somewhere that I haven't been yet, I guess yes. If it's somewhere that I have been yet, what the hell is going on? Honestly, I'd like it to flow. The whole point of this is more the narrative than anything else. I don't feel like I'm solving anything. And if it's going to be a pixel hunt, I'd much prefer to just be told what to do. Because pixel hunts are ridiculous. There's nothing more scintillating than somebody walking around just continually clicking. And it doesn't really feel like you've accomplished anything, it just feels like you've accidentally solved the problem. The infirmary? I don't even remember where it is. I guess I haven't mashed on everything in the infirmary yet.
But yeah, it doesn't really make too much... I mean, I suppose this is a weird ensorcelled area where nothing really makes sense and it's all left up to magic times. But their corpses shouldn't be here anymore. Because they didn't... They died here, but then they were removed. So I don't know. Maybe I'm just being sour. Is it... I've completely forgotten an area. How do I get... It's over here, isn't it? This is it. This is it. This is how I get to the other area. Okay. Okay, okay. I can't go past there, but I can go in here. Okay. Okay. Light and Dark of Heavenly Host Elementary Principal. No, I've already read this. Yeah. Exclamation mark! There's a spirit here! I see him too. Bloody hell. Be careful, don't make eye contact! So I didn't look behind a freaking cloth. Yeah, but Ayumi produces the boy's tongue from her bag, but nothing seems to be attracting his attention. He simply isn't noticing it. In order to give him back his tongue, he needs to see it, to know we have it. So it's got to be directly in his field of vision, huh? Not gonna happen. If his eyes meet mine, I'm dead, right? And then what? Wait, hold up. I've never seen you shake like that before. Alright then, I guess a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. He's all yours. Great. Thanks. Crap! He's looking right at me! Wah! I turned into a pillow. Ryo Yoshizawa! Exclamation mark? That's right, I know your name. Show him the tongue? Yeah. I feel bad for what happened to you, but I can't sympathize with what you're doing. Hurting strangers because of your own despair, pulling them into a horrible place like this, and killing them! You killed our dear friend! You little kid. I can never forgive you for that! Shinazaki! But this is yours. It's part of your body, so I'm going to give it back to you. Handed over Ryu's tongue.
My home!
My tongue!
Now I can speak in spooky voice.
Damn it.
Thank you, miss.
Gasp! Progress! Thank you very much. What? What's going on? Ah! Damn it! Another earthquake! You've got to be kidding me! It's not that this couldn't be a useful earthquake. They're all bad. Ellipsis. I won't get anywhere by wallowing in self-pity here. Yuka, I swear I'll protect you. Please, wait for me. First things first, though, I need to check on Naomi. Oh, never mind. Girl in the red dress. Hey! Hey you! Wait! You're not supposed to be dead! Oh god. It's not Count and Count's family. Oh, okay. Alright, so I have to follow Spook Girl. This doesn't make a lick of sense. I'm going to kill you. Yeah, dude, get a hint. Okay, so this is where Glowy is. This is where the Flashy is. I need to collect. Oh boy. Oh, another Flashy. Someone's cell phone is lying on the ground. Pick it up? Yes. Acquired Seiko cell phone. Lovely. This is Shinohara's, isn't it? Seiko seemed to have been in the middle of texting someone when she dropped her phone. The text entry window is still open. While confirming the phone's owner, Satoshi wound up inadvertently reading the whole thing. Oh yeah, I'm accidentally reading all of this. Shinohara. I'm sorry, Shinohara. I really didn't mean to. I don't think Naomi should see this. Not now, at any rate. Okay, still can't get in there. Yep, don't think that's changed. Now. Not sure I was so intent on following her. Here's the guy who tried to drink his own blood. So, you know, that's a thing. Mum. My. Oh, I mean mummy. Probably. Sure thing, game. There are skeletal remains sprawled across the floor here. Okay, that was a tag I hadn't acquired. Not sure about- Oh! Hey! Hey, Naomi! Satoshi, please don't leave me alone in here like that! Yeah, I'll say! Sorry, I was out looking for Yuka. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Did you find her? No. The corridor that leads to where I saw her last went back into being a wall. I can't find any way of getting to the other building anymore. Other building? There's a whole other building? Yeah. Looks like the school Yuka, Morishige, and I were in is different from this one. Wow. I don't know if it's the grammar or if it's me. We need to find some way of traveling from one space to another. That would be ideal, yeah. Yeah, that'd be useful. Wait a minute. Why are you standing out here instead of waiting inside the infirmary? I was attacked in there earlier by some kind of black shadowy mist, so I was a little scared to be in there, afraid that it might attack me again. Oh, yeah, me bad. You serious? I'm really sorry about that then. Don't worry about it, but there's something in there for sure. I think we should keep our distance. Use a rocket ship to get to another space. Oh, Dave! You bitch. No objections here. Okay, yep. Oh, yeah. Now that I have her, I can go get the glowy. So let's go do that. The only point of having a companion is so that I can pick up a glowing object. Maybe some flavor text along the way, but mostly the glowing objects. They're the important things in the game. Not saving my friends. Mummy. Your mummy's not here now, son. You're in the man's army ghost house. Okay. So, glowy is from the first gap, three across and one down. Is this going to be a thing where I can tell it to stay? No, I have to do it on the other side. Alright. It's gone! Come in this side and suddenly it's over there. This sure seems awfully familiar. Sure does. Three and one down. Oh, come on. Wait, where is it on this side? So from that gap, two across? Is that two or three? Or two across from standing there. Okay. I can do this. Puzzles are easy. If it actually allows me to freaking... No? Oh, okay. There, it did work. Alright. Yeah, that's right. There was dialogue there. It pretty much said, please stand here. And she said, sure, no problem. I'll stand on the other side of Spooky Room, even though I've had friends die. Naomi, now, grab it. Okay, got it. It's probably a small key. Acquired... Oh, Custodian's key. We can finally go watch that video cassette. Nicely done in there. In fact, you seemed totally unfazed. Did you figure out what we needed to do on your own or something? Actually, I had to do something similar before with Seiko.
I had to do something similar before with Seiko.
Did you? Same here, but with Yuka.
Wait, no!
Let's keep moving. We'll find her. I know we will. Yeah, I have my doubts. At least the custodian's room's right here. Yes, please. Let's go solve more of this mystery. This murder house mystery. Wow, okay. Oh, never mind. Who turned out the lights? What the? What's going on? Why is it so cold? Ugh, something really smells. And it's pitch black in here. Can you find a light switch anywhere? I'll try. Is this the light switch? Found it! Woo! Thanks. Man, it does stink in here, and it's not just mold, is it? No, it's probably corpses. Probably not. It's probably corpses in here. It's an old Japanese-style fusuma sliding door, presumably opening to a closet. It's torn and stained in equal measure throughout its surface.
Hey! Who turned out the lights? Hey! Who turned out the lights?
Something seems off about this closet. I get the feeling this is one door we shouldn't open. Please open it. That's where the corpses are! Alright, fine. Inside the cabinet, there's a notebook labeled Night Guard Logbook and a few crumpled pieces of paper. Heavenly Host Elementary School. Confinement. Tau. Now taking applications. The sheets of paper contain what appears to be a seemingly endless list of names. The lettering is worn, however, making it impossible to confirm exactly what's written. Alright, so nothing else of consequence. Something sticky seems to have melted all over its surface. There are stains everywhere. Okay, television. There's a Video 8 camcorder lying on top of the TV. Its cassette deck is empty. Its batteries also seem to have run out, however. As the LCD display... Hold on a sec. I'm just gonna have a drink of water. Maybe it will revitalize me. Its batteries also seem to have run out, however, as the LCD display isn't turning on. There's nothing, that sentence is easy. What is something this recent doing in a place this old? Maybe it belonged to someone who was brought here, like us. Yeah, that does make sense. Unfortunately, there's no cord here to hook it up to the TV, and it's out of batteries. So it doesn't look like we'll be able to get much use out of it. Oh, a note! Just appeared! There's a magazine article here from a publication called Strange But True, Stories of the Occult. It's a follow-up to a previous report. Read it? Oh yeah. Strange But True, Stories of the Occult, Chasing Down the Hidden Past of the Cursed School Buildings, follow-up by Ko Kibiki. Let's talk a bit about Yoshikazu Yanagihori, beloved son of Heavenly Host Elementary's principal, Takemine Yanagihori. The man was a born instructor, pure and simple. He took up the mantle as soon as he could and performed his duties with peerless panache. But then the illness struck, and little by little, his winning personality gave way to pure instinct. He was slowly losing all sense of identity. Although the cause of this illness was unknown, its effect were anything but. The good teacher had begun reverting to a childlike state. He began carrying an antique doll with him at all times, a memento from a long-forgotten festival, perhaps, given to him by his late mother. His behavior during class degraded quickly. More often than not, his lectures would cease before the period's end, and he'd begin wailing mournfully. Finally, several months prior to the kidnapping and murder incident, Yoshikazu reached a point where he could no longer communicate his thoughts. Although he still understood others, he became virtually incapable of forming words without intense focus. I'm having the same problem! Given all the evidence mounted against him, Yoshikazu was arrested on multiple counts of kidnapping, murder, and desecration of the dead. But due to his mental condition, he was never able to confess his involvement in these crimes, nor even properly discuss them with authorities. Everything hinged on the testimony of a sole survivor, one Sachiko Shinozaki, age 7. It's Sachiko! Like the forever curse. I mean, charm. In search of the truth behind the less scientific afflictions this incident spurned, I, of course, chose to follow the trail of this mysterious little girl. Those who have seen the infamous newspaper photos accompanying this story may remember Sachiko best as the girl with the strikingly unusual red dress. It's hard not to feel sympathy for someone so young, forced to watch other children her age being tortured and killed one by one. And certainly, if I were to find Miss Shinozaki? And secure an interview, there would be some real moral concerns about digging up such painful memories. Shinozaki. But then again, she's been a full-grown, hopefully well-adjusted adult for over 10 years at this point. So why is she dead? By now, she should have been able to look back upon these horrific events with some objectivity, given a more thorough account of what happened that day, and give that. Grammar. Grammar's hard, what can I say? Oh, I teleported again. Wheeze, wheeze, chatter. I'm impressed, Shinozaki. You're far stronger than I thought. Totally fearless, in fact. I was scared out of my mind. My brain is still struggling to make sense of all this. Okay, but look, the ghost is gone, I guess. We really managed to appease it. Are you all right? You should probably dry your tears and blow your nose at least. Snork! It's the Snorks! Ack, what the hell? Not on my shirt! Didn't I tell you before you shouldn't say things like that? What are you... two? Ugh, that's really gross! Not good. She's not normally like this, Shinozaki. Shinozaki. She has the same surname as the ghost in the red dress. Ooh, I probably should have noticed that earlier. Okay, now what? Can I go this way now? No. Okay. I'm waiting for a trigger. There's gonna be a trigger. Something has to happen. Otherwise, I will not be able to continue. How about over here? Is it warm now? Yes! Okay, let's not go this way. The air is really heavy and makes my ears ring. Can't believe there's a second wing to this place. I had no idea. Great, we're back to exploration. The tongue. There's something wrong with my tongue today. Giggle. Still nothing, just a giggle. My doll hasn't said anything. Wonder if the custodian's door's open now that I unlocked it with the other characters. Nope. Still locked. Still in a different space. Okay, well, there's several other places to check if I can continue from there. Nope, that is still up. I cannot go in that direction. Come on, doll, tell me what to do next. That's your one job. You have one job, doll. Other than to be slightly creepy, you're supposed to tell me where to go. Better save. Where? All right, let's check to see if somebody's written anything on the board, the desk. Nothing new.
May I go this direction now? No! Wow! So fun not being able to go anywhere! Maybe there's a new book. Is there a new book pulled out? No! I like how we just got to where we were supposed to be, and then rather than leave us another breadcrumb, it left us absolutely nothing. Or maybe it was in the infirmary. So yeah, I'm still sort of in two minds of what to play after this. I definitely want to immediately pick up another talkie. So it's probably going to be a dating sim just for shits and giggles. And then yes, as Blood mentioned earlier, Danganronpa. Fantastic game series. It's like a whodunit murder mystery closed room kind of thing, and it's just fun. And rather than actually play it, I read through both games on Something Awful, which was a weird experience to read a game. But I suppose, at the end of the day, those kinds of games you read regardless, so it didn't make that much difference. Okay, maybe there's something in here. I've read both Ron Paul's. Yes. Okay. Monthly goal. How to remove a tongue. 2. Draft. Cut the tongue with a pair of big scissors. It's so thick and warm, but how will you know whose tongue it is later when you have a bunch more? Simple. Label it with a name tag. The tongue is very tender and squishy. So stick the safety pin in deep to keep the label from slipping away. Awesome. The diary is no different. There's an anatomical diagram of the human body tacked to the wall. Looking closely, each individual organ seems to be bloodstained and swollen, as if it could burst forth with a spray of gore at any moment. There's even one part in the second where you have to make a really dumb guess at what happened. Yeah, the internal logic in the game felt a bit hinky. I suppose I'll get to that when I play it, but man, I don't know. I mean, that tongue thing I hadn't read before. Top half of the article. I've already read the top half of the article. Good. Can we just sleep on it? Can we just wait, please? No, no, no. Okay. And they were like, the Ace Attorney wouldn't even get that. I don't like dumb guesses in games. I also don't like breadcrumb trails ending. It's just suddenly nothing. I'm meted out with no information whatsoever. Okay, doll, can you do something, please? The doll trap. Closed. Doesn't want any part of it whatsoever. And this is annoying me every time I get here. Giggle! Stop laughing at me! It's really quite rude. Guess I could look in that place that I looked previously. Just in case something reappeared. Not very likely. It's just, No. Okay. Good to know. Very good to know. Well, that's just it. The doll hasn't said anything yet. And I thought I went everywhere. Anyway, let's just check again, I guess. I'm so terribly sorry. It's not my fault they designed the game this way. Maybe here. Doll, yes! Weep, weep! Go to where the floor collapsed, but then got better. One step rooster, 10 paces rat. That was here, wasn't it? One step rooster, 10 step rat. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nothing. Oh, hold on a second. Web storage version. I'm not interested, thank you. Oh, Balzac! No, 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 no! Did this also get better? How am I supposed to be searching while I'm getting chased? Oh, come on. I'm trying to help you. I'm really trying. Sort of. Now, I don't know if that's the only place that the floor was repaired. Nah. That's not looking good, is it? How about here? I'm not getting any messages that it was repaired, though. What a pain in the ass! Yeah, so this has to be it. And it was one step and then 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nothing. Good. I don't like you, I don't like you, ghost pants. Oh, look at me. I had my tongue removed. Wah, wah, wah. Was that the right floor? Was that the correct floor place? Am I on the right track? Because so far it's the only place that's actually had a message about the floor being repaired. Oh crap! That wasn't right. Come on. Come on, down here. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Oh. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hey! One of the floorboards here is slightly raised. Peering through the crack, you can just barely make out something shiny in the dark recesses below. Try to pull it out. Yes! It better be her tongue. Shuffle. From beneath the floorboards, you manage to fish out a crank-like key that resembles the winder from an old-fashioned pocket watch. The heck is this? Doesn't look like it would fit any door I know. Acquired winder. Well, we know where to use that anyway. We have to go watch the movie Crank up here. Wait, no, it was through this room, wasn't it? What are we going for? This feels like a pretty long chapter. Maybe it's just due to my ineptitude. The winder you found looks like it'll fit perfectly in the keyhole at the base of the lever. Use it? Yes. It did indeed slip into the device without any trouble, but nothing happened. Oh, come on! I agree with Blondie. The lever is still stuck, but it seems to have a bit more give than it did before. There's a space for it to go down one more notch. Try forcing it. Yes! Grr-arr! Gah! Oh, good. Of course, it's around where Miss Ghostface is wandering, so... She's just annoyed that she can't give French kisses anymore. How long are you planning on streaming, do you think? I'm going to finish this chapter. I'll finish the chapter because I have about 4 hours of online courses to do for work. So I was going to stream something after this, but because I remembered I have to do that by the end of the month... And it's pretty much the end of the month. I have to go do that afterwards. So I'll finish up there and then I'll do the draw after I finish this chapter. So, an hour or two? I don't know how long this chapter is. Wow, get a load of this place. It's got showers and everything. I bet the water doesn't work. It hurts. Make it stop. Oh god, my head. That was unpleasant. Blood? Shinazaki! Are you blood? Are you alright? Did you feel something again? Uh-huh. Wince. Another nosebleed. If it's just her nose, it's fine. But if a blood vessel burst... if a blood vessel burst in her brain or something, it would be the blurst of times. Here, Shinazaki. Stuff some tissues up your nose to stop the bleeding. Thanks. I have some of my own, but since you got yours out already... Yeah, go ahead. Did the ghost get to her? No, she's been a little off since before that. I think she's probably reached her limit. She needs to rest. Oh good. More ghosts. It's the blood from Ayumi's nose. Yes, it is. Your own reflection stares back at you. Strangely, you have more wrinkles than you remember. Come on, let's have a shower. The bucket is crammed full of discarded underwear, all twisted up, like wrung out dish rags. Why? Clicking on everything. Probably just need to leave the room. A lot of ghosts in the bathroom. It's where ghosts congregate. Oh.
Oh. Oh.
No running by the pool. Well, that's okay because I can only move at a brisk freaking walk. A pool, huh? Can't even see the other side of it with all the rain. Shiver. Shudder. Alright, here goes. Shinazaki, this clearly isn't working. Why don't I take the doll for a bit? You'll catch your death of cold out here. Go back inside. I can handle the search. Just you wait for me in the locker room. Cause I'm a man, and this is kind of sexist, but not really. And what's going to happen if a ghost shows up again, Do you think you'll be able to handle it? Don't worry about me. If anything happens, I'll call you. And you can come to my rescue. Ellipsis. Alright, just don't do anything stupid. Thank you. You say something? What does he think he is, Harrison Ford? I've got to try and lighten her load as much as possible. I don't think she can handle so much on her own. Or much more of this. Now I'm just adding lines. What's up with this murky water? There's no telling what could happen, be down there. All I know is I wouldn't be caught dead in this pool. Of course, I can't really swim, so I would probably be dead in this pool. Okay. Alright, hold on. Caution. Confirm all swimmers have vacated the pool before draining. There's a sign on the door that says pump room. The door is locked. Really? Oh, shiny. Is it the lock? This looks like it's a key. It's lodged in two tiles. Try to dig it out. Yes. Acquired pump room key. Well, that was easy. Pump room, huh? I've had enough. Uh-oh. Interrobang? Oh shit. Was that? No, there's no way. Come on, give me a break here. Screw that. Straight to the pump room. I haven't been able to save for a little while. You bastards. Yes. Yeah, the key was rusted and it broke. A crude label is written on the piece of tape attached to the device and water pump right below it. It says the slot is for the lever or handle. Ah, crap, I don't have a lever or handle. The valve is around drainage. Turn it. Yes! I had to read really fast. Oh, oh! What was that? Did something get stuck in the drain? Oh, thank God. Ugh, timers. That is just mean! You don't- Oh my God! No, please don't be! Gasp! No! Shinazaki! That's Shinazaki! Why? Why did you- Oh! Uwag! Indeed, Uwag! Bad end? Ew! Ew! I'll freaking say! Wrong end indeed! Well, I guess that's what happens when you rush to save someone! They become death. Bloody hell. Turn the drain on while she is in the water, not pleasant. Well, yeah, I know, but he didn't want to go in the water previously. I just assumed that he wouldn't want to go in the water that time. Obviously, incorrectly. You know what they say about assumptions? It makes an ass out of you and Mchen. Oh God, how much did I lose? Oh man, where was I up to? Oh, this chokes chode. I think I have to do this all over again, do I? There's no ghost lady walking around, so okay. Yep, skip, 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 please. Now she's wandering. Yes? No? No? Whoops! Slight error. I mean, come on. Well, it's like, she's, oh no, she fell in the pool. If I was in a rush, then surely the whole point, well, okay, apparently I'm not supposed to drain the pool while she's in there. I'm supposed to go in and save her. Fair enough. I mean, I guess that's the reason. It's just, I'm in a rush. She can only hold her breath for 2 minutes or something. Actually, pretty good lung capacity for an anemic who's been bleeding and getting possessed by ghosts. When you think about it, I don't think I could hold my breath for 2 minutes underwater. Like, full stop. Thank you for working for once, Moobot. Yeah, okay, Kang, thank you, yes, good. Okay, this time I might save it. Just in case. I'm a little worried. Actually, after mentioning it, the one thing I'm slightly annoyed about is if the mic quality is low for some reason. I don't like the idea of having to get a new microphone. Let us see. Okay, good. Oh no, you bled slightly, and there was a ghost that walked right here. The locker is empty. Okay, well, I was thinking maybe there was something there. Something I missed. Apparently, all I missed was my friend falling into the pool. I know, I knew she fell into the pool. Here we go again. I was so eager to help her not die. I was just trying to help. Okay. All right, go. Let me move. Da, da, Oh, okay, so first I have to check the locker room, maybe. And it's like, she's not in there! Shinazaki! Damn it, she's not here. I guess that really was her in there then. What the hell was she thinking, dumbass? I want to check this locker. No, that's fine. Oh, let's just have a leisurely stroll back out here then. Let's take our time. What is wrong with me? What am I doing? I should never have taken my eyes off her. This is all my fault, goddammit. Just get in the pool. Just get in there. Hey, Shinazaki! Shinazaki! You were around here. Pretty sure this is where the waves were coming from. It is. Lots of ellipses. Ellipses? Another one. Oh no. Did I pick the wrong spot? Wasn't the drain around here? I'm gonna run out of time. Oh. I know it was around here somewhere. I've got two more chances. This isn't gonna end well. Great, okay. Sorry, but in a panic situation, I'm supposed to have noted exactly where somebody was. I'm a bad friend. Yeah. Oh well. Yes, she's dead. And the body's just gonna float up. Yep. Aww. Oops. Oopsie doodle. I guess I messed up. Okay. Do it all in the right order, Chris. Don't mess up once, Chris. Stop screwing up, Chris. Yes! Yes, exactly. She stays under the water while... That's a very good point, Dave. If she was unconscious underwater... But if she's being possessed or something, then the spirit is keeping her underwater until she drowns. Alright. I'll just have to make note. I will have to be more mindful. So I thought the drain was in the middle, but I thought the bubbles were coming from that patch. It's almost as if I have to kill her to find out where she is underwater. Okay. 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 Got the key. Pick it up. Oh, it's under that. Okay, I saw it. I saw it. Okay, I saw it. Alright. Alright, okay, okay. So I click this, it says, ah, oh, she's still in the locker room, then I go to the locker room, she's in there, and she's underneath those dashed lines. Maybe. Okay. Okay. Alright, come on, let's go save her life. Oh, fuck you! That's where it was! That is exactly where it was! Oh, you cheating game! Where did she come up? Oh, get knotted! That is precisely where I saw the bubbles! It's her! Don't worry, Shinazaki, I'm pulling you up!
Unbelievable.
Was I a little too high? Or were they being dicks and I had to try it twice? Who knows? I saved her life. It's time to give a mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Shinazaki! Shinazaki! Come on, breathe already, damn it! Hack. Sputter. Cough, cough, cough. Gasp. Cough. Cough, cough. Wheeze. She's fine now. Deep sigh. God, don't worry me like that. She died in the drain. You back with me now? Ellipsis. So tell me, why the hell did you jump into the pool? Pant, pant. You called me out there, didn't you? I what? I heard your voice, so I ran outside, and after that, I don't remember much else. The next thing I knew, my vision was all this sickening green color, and my mouth was full of water. God damn it! Was this the work of those ghosts again? Can't believe they can trick us so easily. Well, I freaking can. There's got to be something in that pool. Ulk.
There's nothing there in my tooth.
Oh god, it's like algae or something. Spit. Wonder if the showers still work. Probably not. Let's just check the shower cam. Nothing. Big surprise. I can't get rid of this horrible taste, and I smell absolutely putrid. I hate this. And the crying begins. Wah! Oh! Wine sob. Well, she had a little bit to drink. How does she think I feel? Shinazaki? How about we go into the rain and wash ourselves off a little? Though I don't know how much rainwater will... I don't know how much help rainwater will be for getting that taste out of your mouth, unless you don't, I don't know, cup your hands and take a mouthful and wash it out. Alright, let's go then. After this, I guess we'll need to figure out how to dry our clothes. Wait? This... First world problems with these kids. Feeling better? Yeah, surprisingly, I was able to rinse out my mouth pretty thoroughly. Of course you were. Were you? That's good. So, Shinazaki, while I was out here, I came across a room at the back I kind of like to check out. I came across a room at the back I'd kind of like to check out. I'll go with you. That's probably for the best. Let's do it. Now I can drain this water without killing you terribly. That would be awful. imagine if I'd emptied the water out while she was still in the pool. Thinking that, oh, I don't know, a drain would be very difficult to kill someone with. That'd be stupid, wouldn't it? Let's try that again, shall we? What was I thinking? So dumb. Nothing else of note in here. I'll just look at this, even though it'll say it needs a lever. Yep. Okay. So now I should be able to get to that note, and there's probably body parts in here. It's a corpse of a very tiny individual being pickled in this filthy brine for so long, it seems to have bloated its skin into a patchwork of pustules. That is Kanzuki Saito. Delicious. It's the body of a female student rotting and decayed. Mitsugi Kamijo. I removed the wheel from the water pump and threw it into the pool. Hopefully, that'll keep anyone from finding the little treasure I left in the spigot. That bitch killed my friends. She can spend eternity without a tongue for all I care. Yeah, I suppose so.
but not generally while someone's draining a pool. It's generally someone's foot getting stuck in there and them drowning like an idiot. Long time exposure to the dirty contaminated water has left it quite a mess. Hirune Takana. And who's this? That's just a rotting individual. Okay, well, I have to check the spigot then. Is this the spigot? Is this? No, not this. Nope. Okay, so it must be in the wheelhouse. I mean, the pump room. Oh, I'm not using the D-pad again, like a chump. Alright. Let's see if I can search it. Huh. Well, I'm a dumb. What's a spigot? Is this an Americanization of something? Is a spigot a tap? I really would have thought it was this thing. Oh, it's essentially an oversized faucet or pump, obviously used for filling the pool. Its entire surface is covered in moss and seems to have absorbed some of the water, puffing it up with a thick blackish-green coat of ultra-shiny slime. Huh. Am I looking for something else in here? It all just looks... the thing with their art style is everything is so low-res that sometimes it's difficult to tell what's supposed to be something and what's supposed to be nothing. Hmm. Let's just read that again. I removed the wheel from the water pump and threw it into the pool. Hopefully that'll keep anyone from finding the little treasure I left in the spigot. What is a spigot? That bitch killed my friends, blah blah blah. What the hell is a spigot? I don't know what a spigot is. Please speak English. English, motherfucker, do you speak it? What is a spigot? What is a spigot? A little help? Anyone? I don't understand. You need the wheel, which is somewhere in the pool area. The spigot is part of the pump itself, I think. Am I on a pixel hunt again? Because I don't see a wheel in here. You would think that if it was a wheel, it'd be pretty obvious. Why does that tile look different? Ah, it's nothing. do I have to pop a corpse to find it? It's not inside a corpse, is it? Do you have a wheel inside of you? No. Terribly sorry. See, I would have thought it would get caught in one of these drains, but... Spam near the drain. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm doing. Oh, the dim lights around you are reflecting off something deep inside the drainage grate. Try to fish it out? Yes. What is this thing? Some kind of handle? What the hell is a spigot? Not a plumber. Didn't realize I needed to be a qualified plumber to understand this game. Okay. Good.
Ugh, that's as far as it's gonna go, I think. It's too rusted to turn anymore. Okay. Alright, well, everything's turned to max. I've got everything cranked to 11. And it's probably washed it out of here. Yep, there we go. Alright, a spigot is a tap. Or a faucet. Whatever you want to call it. It's a small hemp bag stained with copious amounts of blood. It seems to have fallen from the spigot. So that was a spigot. An elementary schooler's student ID name tag is attached to it. Heavenly Host Elementary School, Class 1-6, Tsukiko Tsuji. Tsukiko Tsuji. The bag appears to contain a severed human tongue. Olg. It's a girl's name. It's a girl's name. We have Tokiko's tongue. Or Tokiko. Tokiko. For all those wonderful weeaboos out there. Or people that just are Japanese. It's not their fault. They didn't choose to be Japanese. Okay, I thought that maybe, just maybe, something would end up in that locker. I actually want to save it before I talk to this ghost, just in case it decides to kill me unceremoniously, which has been known to happen in this game, in this wonderful game. Also, sorry for anyone who wants to see the ferrets at the moment. They're out sleeping, poor things. They had a fast day yesterday, so I don't want to put too much stress on them. Giggle. Hey, ghosty, where are you? Aww. Exclamation mark. Which one do we give it to? Oh, let me think. Probably the one that has a head. Because I think the one without the head probably also needs their head. You.
Give it back. Give it back.
Yogg.
Give me back my eye!
Oh shit! How am I supposed to know whose tongue we've got? Pull out the tongue bag. That looks like a girl, but I think they're both girls, aren't they? I think I messed up. Please be the right one, Tsukiko Tsuji. This is yours, isn't it? I'm giving it back. Offered the spirit Tokiko's tongue. No! I'm wrong! Ah, did we pick the wrong girl? The deep black socket where the girl's spirit left eye once sat transfixes on Ayumi's gaze. It begins slowly expanding in size. Ooh, ah! I can't stand! Move my body. And I ruined everything. The girl socket continues to grow, slowly and methodically enveloping Ayumi until only blackness remains. The world vanishes into nothingness as the empty cavity becomes an all-encompassing void, blotting out the whole of existence. Suddenly in the distance, a tiny white face breaks through the darkness, shining with its own unnatural light. No, please, no, I'm so scared, please. Chris ruins everything once again. The face seems distorted as if being viewed through the water. Its expression shifts and wobbles for a bit until finally, with some effort, the image clears. You've seen this face before. Somebody, please help! Bad end. I'm not trying to stretch this out. I actually have stuff to do. It's just that this keeps happening. Oh, whoops. Whoops. Put the whoops in. Whoops, I screwed up again. Okay, I get it. Yes, I'm a bad person. I'm terrible at this game. I had two choices and I chose poorly. Thankfully, I did a safety save, because I'm not a complete idiot, and I understand my failings. My many, many failings. My copious amounts of failings. I understand them all. Okay. I'll be finished shortly, I think, maybe. If I don't keep messing it up. Which one do we give it to? Let's give it to the one that doesn't have a head. Gurgle, gurgle. Ooh-ah! She's got no head above her chin. Gurgle, gulp, gurgle. Gasp! How am I supposed to know whose tongue we've got? Pull out the tongue bag. Oh yeah, I'm gonna give her a bit of tongue. Gurgle, gasp, gurgle. The little girl's spirit is staggering towards Ayumi, blood gushing up from her gaping cross-section of her head as she walks. Please be the right one, Tokiko Tsuji! Exclamation mark! This is yours, isn't it? I'm giving it back! Offered the spirit to Tokiko's tongue. Sputter, cough, cough. Whoa, what happened? I don't know, I can't see, you're in the way. The other ghost is headed this way. We have to run. Bye. I'm running. Okay. Now what? Oh, damn, Sachiko. I really don't like you. I'm gonna follow you anyway. Weep, weep. Here goes the antique doll again. Here we go again. He has the same attitude towards this as I do. Where the hell's it gonna take us this time? Weep, weep. Where your friend was splattered. Jesus. The floorboards beneath that wall. Oh no! Oh no! Right under her globby entrails. Where the floor dips and the blood pools. Drip drop, drip drop. Smelly, smelly, icky, icky. Get in there good and dig it out. You're a terrible doll. No. Oh, throwing the doll again. No! You getting a good laugh out of this, you sick son of a bitch? God, if that's where it is. Yeah, that's where it is. I'm not sure we can ever bring ourselves to get it. Just do it. Is someone there? Oh! Morishige, you're alive and really creepy. Ah, Kishinuma and the class rep too. I'm very glad to see you both safe and sound. Sob, sob, moan. Hmm? What happened? It's a long story. Where have you been? I was in the second wing until a short while ago, but suddenly lost consciousness. And when I woke up, I felt as if the air had somehow changed. Oh, yes, and I did briefly cross paths with Mochida and his little sister. You did? So they're okay too? They are. Though when I ran into Mochida's sister, it seemed that she and her brother had parted ways. Morishige? What is that in your hand? Ah! Morishige appears to be grasping a blood-soaked pouch in his hands. Hmm? Oh, this? I found it under the floorboards in the hallway. Yeah, just up these stairs. Dun. Is it some kind of charm? Do you want it? Please, take it. I'm merely searching for a certain someone, so I have no need for charms at the present time. Received another tongue bag. Gotta collect those tongue bags. From Morishige. As with the others, there's a student ID name tag attached to the front. Yuki Kano. Well, I should be going now. Is something wrong, class rep? You look like you've seen a ghost. Ah, yes, one more thing, Mochida. One more thing. Mochida said that we should all try to meet in classroom 1A. Okay. Awkward! I'm guessing. It wasn't from, you know, Suzumoto's spot. Maybe it shifted over a few feet and he got it from there. I mean, if he didn't, then. That really freaked me out. Did you see his hands? They were covered in blood!
They were covered in blood!
Sorry, went a bit Seinfeld there for a second.
What is the deal with tongue bags? They're bags for tongues! How many tongues do you have to need bags for them?
Something like that, I don't know. Observational humor, am I right, guys? Giggle. Hey, ghost, I've got parts of you! This girl's missing an eye. All we've got is a tongue. Is that going to be enough? What do we do? Pull out the tongue bag? Yeah. Pant, pant, hick, sob, cry. The girl lowers her head and begins rocking slowly back and forth. Yuki Kano? Haha, oh Dave, you're such a bitch. Gasp. This is for you. It's yours, isn't it? Offered the spirit Yuki's tongue. Ellipsis.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Pant, pant. Collapse. Pant, pant, hack. We did it. We did it, Shinazaki. All three of them. All that's left is the girl in the No! No more! Every time I talk to these ghosts, I feel like I'm getting closer and closer to death itself. Do you have any idea what it's like? I keep picturing how I'll look when I'm dead, and I'm not even trying. It just pops into my head all on its own, and it's such a horrible image. I was drowned. I was in this drain, and parts of me were torn everywhere. I want to go home. I just want to go home. Back to my mom and my sister and Mochida. Ellipsis. Shinazaki. Alright, next one is mine then, okay? Oh! So just try to pull yourself to get. Wah! God damn it, not again! Another earthquake again! This one's big too! Eek! Slap her now! Oh no, it's the hair monster!
One ghost! Two ghosts! Three ghosts!
That takes me back. Oof, was I knocked out? Where am I?
Oh, we're back in school! Yeah!
Ellipsis. Interrobang? Is this our classroom? For real? Shinazaki! Hey, wake up! She's breathing at least. Shinazaki, come on, wake up already!
Gurg.
Kishinuma? Hick, gag, cough. Pant, pant, huh? What? Take a look around you. I can hardly believe it myself, but here we are! No way! Gasp! We're back? For real? Is this really our school? It's really real. Check it out. Here's my desk! Mine too. It's right here. I can't believe it. So it's true. Yeah, we made it. We're home. We're home. But there's only a chapter. There's still a chapter to go. Expletive, yeah. Suck on that, world. Well, we're fine. So, that's cool, right? I never thought I'd live to see home again. The same thing I said.
What?
Guess there's no Satoshi, or Miss Yui, or anyone else, huh? Well, let's go home! Venturing out in search of others, you find that even the janitor has likely gone home. The lights are out and the halls are pitch black. Only the red glow of the light next to the fire extinguisher offers any respite from the quaint, quiet darkness of the school hallway. Standing around in the darkened corridors of our school building at 8 o'clock in the evening just feels so surreal. As the thunder and rain grow in intensity, the windows begin to condensate with moisture, turning white in contrast of the corridor's sea of black. Ellipsis. Is this reality? Was everything up until now just a dream? Where am I right now? What am I doing? Eek! What? Shinazaki? What's wrong? Interrobang. Oh! Hello!
What?
What the hell is this? Shudder, shiver, it's not over, is it? Why isn't it over? Why? Damn it! Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality! Oh, hey, ghost child. Gasp! It's you! No! Go back! Don't come any closer! Pant, pant, whimper.
Ooh. It's a ghost, isn't it?
It was rainy after school, in the evening, just like this one. On the day I was kidnapped. I remember I had a fight with my mom that morning.
Why is she telling us this? I have no idea.
I didn't want to see her face. So after school, I decided that instead of going home, I'd park myself in the outdoor walkway for a little and watch the rain. That's when Mr. Yoshikazu showed up. He sat down next to me. I told him about my fight with Mom, and he said, listened really closely and just kept saying, He was sick and couldn't speak much, but was a very kind man. I really liked him. But then... Sob. Hick, you too? I'm so sorry.
She's so tiny. She must be fifth grader? Yuki Kano, right? Ellipsis. Thank you for what you did back there. Oh, wait.
For making the effort to help those of us who were killed in the school.
Damn it. Didn't we succeed though? Why are you still here?
You didn't.
But we returned your tongues. We gave you back the ability to tell your story. And we even got your murderer to repent for what he did. Murderer. Is it just that you can't forgive him no matter what?
Appeasing us isn't about forgiveness. It doesn't matter if we forgive or not. Repentance is between the criminal and the victim. It's the sole act capable of moving us. And we exist as fragments of the school ground upon which heavenly host is sealed. I believe that moving us is your best course of action. But it's not enough. His repentance just wasn't enough.
So you're saying his words, the words spoken by the doll, weren't good enough to appease you?
That's not...
Hmm? So what then? Why do you feel the need to trap one innocent stranger after another in that godforsaken school? You child spirits are the ones who summoned us there, aren't you?
That's not true!
The hell do you mean by that? I was going to do this.
We're just the cogs that hold the closed spaces together.
But you killed Suzumoto, didn't you? Wait! Huh? Let's hear her out.
Ellipsis! I'm just glad I was able to get even the two of you back to safety.
Why the hell are you suddenly so concerned about us in Terabang? I heard about a situation like this from my sister once. A lost soul whose life was ended violently and abruptly, leaving her with a mountain of worries and regrets. It's kind of like stopping short at the edge of madness. With all sorts of thoughts and feelings swirling around in your head, your kindly nature and your sudden hatred and panic begin to spin around and around, and you just start acting out without any sort of control. Your sister, some kind of medium or something? Yeah, something like that. So what you're saying is, this little girl and the creepy little girl we met before are two sides of the same coin?
Ellipsis.
I feel for you, I really do, so please, please, bring back the rest of them. Mochida, Miss Shishido, everyone else too, bring them all back home.
Ellipsis.
Come on, you can do it, right?
I don't think that's possible anymore.
Why not?
Those closed spaces have eaten a lot of innocent souls, far too many in fact. The grudges of those who died here have filled every last corner of them. There's no room left. And because the agony and pain has nowhere else to go, it's begun feeding on the minds of souls like us who are bound there. It won't be long before I turn back into a vengeful spirit who attacks people like you without mercy.
Ellipsis. So, we're going to lose you as an ally then? So why don't you just hurry up and bring them home right now? Isn't there any other way of us to save Mochida and the others?
There may be one way.
What is it?
I think you already know you have to return to the closed spaces. Find all four of us Heavenly Host serial kidnapping and murder victims. And put us all to rest. Then the closed spaces won't have their cogs anymore, so they shouldn't begin to fade from existence. And you might get your friends back.
You expect us to go back? And this time, instead of having one person left to appease, we have to go back to the drawing board and appease all four of you? Why couldn't you tell us the reason our previous efforts weren't good enough? What is there to hide?
It's just... it kind of sucks, okay? Something I don't want to remember, but... if you really want to know, I'll tell you. I'll tell you everything that happened.
So much exposition! Yuki's spirit gently took hold of Ayumi's hand, and in an instant, their two beings seemed to merge together into a single mind. Ah! What's going... ah! Shinazaki? It hurts! Ah! Ugh. Huh? Here we go. What happened to me? Didn't I pass out? Why am I fully aware right now? I can't see a thing. And I can't move. It's like that feeling you get when you're really tired. Sleep paralysis, I think. Oh dear. Oh dieu. Ah! Where? Why can't I move? Bad things are going to happen. Sachiko Shinazaki, the little girl in the red dress, and the only survivor of the horrific murders that occurred in Heavenly Host Elementary School. Following the incidents, Sachiko's family fled from the area, moving to another prefecture to escape the frightful memories that remained here. Strangely, however, I've been unable to locate any other recordings of the Shinazaki family. No matter where I look, the only information I can find about them comes from the newspaper reports of the Heavenly Host murders. Granted, when the elementary school becomes the stage for a grisly incident such as this, perpetrated by none other than the principal's own son, it stands to reason that the scandal would serve as a primary focus for public interest, with all other details fading into the background. So of course, after learning that Sachiko was safe, further news of her whereabouts was largely ignored in favor of the media circus surrounding the school. But there's more to it than that. People weren't just uninterested in learning of Sachiko's history or whereabouts, there was simply no data to be had. I can't move my body because of sleep paralysis, I guess. But I can't clearly see the room I'm in now. There's one boy and two girls in here, aside from myself. I recognize them. They're the children who were killed in Heavenly Host during that incident, but they're all still alive. Unfortunately, they're all bound hand and foot and just sprawled out on the floor. And so am I. That's the real reason I can't move. Weep! Weep! Wah-ha! Ah! Arg! Somebody please save me! Gasp! Ooh! Ah! No! Stop! No! Please! No! I! Her eye! Eyes! Ow! Erg! Gah! No! I can't see! Now I'm blindfolded. I can't see a thing that's happening to me. And since my hands and feet are tied up, I can't remove the blindfold either. That just makes everything so much worse. I guess because I can't see, I begin to listen more intently. Frightened sobbing. The helpless cries of the other children echo off the walls of the cramped room. I'm so scared. It feels like my head's going to explode. What are you going to do to me? Why am I blindfolded? Untie me! Cut the ropes! I want to be able to use my hands and feet! Please! Please! I kept begging and pleading, but all I heard in response was the man walking away from me. In order, okay? In order? Ah! 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 Expletive! I've never heard screaming like this before. It's pure primal terror, cutting through the air like a perfect sine wave. It's the boy at the end. It feels like he's screaming for an eternity. I think he's being killed right now. It's almost over, I think. My God, what the hell is he doing to him? Something very wet. Expletive! No one deserves this. Why isn't God allowing him to fall unconscious so he doesn't have to suffer? That was quite red. It's been at least half an hour now. Those inhuman screams of a young boy being ripped apart from the inside have finally come to a halt. No! Without even a single moment of silence, the first of the girls in line is next to scream for her life. And the symphony goes on. God. I can't take any more of this. I'm losing my mind. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. Very wet noises. Gurgle, hick, choke.
Oof.
Is it still going on? Come on, just die already. Yeah, just die already. Die already. God, what is wrong with me? You know what? I don't care. Just get it over with and leave me in peace. Yeah, just die, you inconsiderate child. Finally, after hearing the sounds like a heavy object being dropped, the noises stopped and the room grew quiet again. Thump, thump, thump. My turn! Those footsteps are getting closer. All my hair is standing on end at this point. Everything below my stomach feels like it's frozen, like I've suddenly been stricken with severe diarrhea. We can't get away from the bathroom. In order? God, why am I relieved by the silence? That means I'm next! That means it's my turn now! Ah! Someone's got me by the hair. They're pulling my head up. And taking off my blindfold, which means I get to see the face of my killer. The four missing children were found in a basement room at Heavenly Host Elementary School, unused and officially sealed since the building's construction. When authorities entered, they were greeted with an inhumanly horrible sight. Based upon the evidence at hand, the murder weapon was determined to be a pair of large sewing scissors found at the hands of the accused. Investigators suspected some hesitation on the man's part, however, as the deceased victim's wounds did not indicate that his full strength had been used. Nonetheless, he had clearly acted with extreme malicious intent. The official cause of death for the three murdered children had been listed as loss of blood following the removal of the tongue. But the actual state of affairs was not quite so clinical, nor ever so pleasant, if you can believe it. The following details have been extrapolated from information previously unreleased to the Republic, or at least the Republic? The public, or at least previously unreported by the news outlets. These details of the crime are based on the official police testimony of Sachiko Shinozaki herself. Evidently, the victims were bound, blindfolded, and spaced out upon the floor, then killed one by one. One was repeatedly stabbed in the abdomen with the aforementioned pair of scissors, and then had many of his internal organs forcefully dug out. His discarded innards were found partially buried beneath the earthen floor of the basement room. Another was stabbed in the head dozens upon dozens of times, to such an extent that all the flesh and bone above her jawline was essentially minced away. Mmm, delicious. With my blindfold removed, the sight that appeared before me was more horrific than anything I could possibly have imagined. The person staring back at me, brandishing a blood-soaked pair of sewing scissors, wasn't the large man from earlier at all! It was one of the children! At least it wasn't the count. It was the little girl, her face dyed red with the blood of her victims. Sup? She was staring intently at me with soulless grey eyes, and then she just started giggling. Snip, snap, snip, snip. Ah, ah, ah! Giggle, giggle. She was opening and closing the bloodied scissors over and over again. The sound kept echoing through the room. Then she took those dull, rusty, thoroughly blood-soaked blades and slowly brought them closer and closer to my left eye. Yeah. How? Why? Why is it you? Giggle, giggle. No, no, no! Ayee! Ugh! Gurgle! The third victim was stabbed in the left eye an indeterminate number of times, until her eyeball became soup-like in consistency. She eventually just left like that, slowly bleeding to death in horrible agony. Strangely, it was only after these mutilations had already been inflicted that the killer went back and severed the victim's tongues. Learning the truth about the proceedings is shocking, even to me, and makes it nearly impossible to accept the murderer as anything but a monster. And bearing witness to every moment of this was a 7-year-old girl named Sachiko. In many ways, she's the most pitiable and long-suffering of them all. But it was through her tearful, frightened testimony that Yoshikazu Yanagihori was officially charged. I hate his surname. Now, going back to the hunt for information on this unfortunate girl's whereabouts, it was her words that ultimately led to Yoshikazu's sentencing. Therefore, it comes as no real surprise that her sensitive information pertaining to her and her family would be withheld. That's to be expected. What's not expected, however, is that there's not even the slightest trace of information left to find, as if it simply never existed. Therefore, I cannot help but consider alternative possible explanations, and I remind you that this is mere conjecture, but one question kept nagging me at the back of my mind. Was Yoshikazu really the murderer of these three victims? Is it possible that his crime was not actually perpetrated by him at all? Think about it. In his final days, Yoshikazu was incapable of communicating with others through speech. And despite his childlike reversion, he'd always been a personable and friendly man. As the saying goes, he wouldn't have hurt a fly. All his relatives, friends and neighbors confirmed as much, shocked to hear that such a kindly man could commit these unconscionable atrocities. He certainly had no motive for the crime either. There was nothing for him to gain from it. Then again, he may simply have lost his mind. Look at his father. It was around the same time that the principal suddenly began speaking in tongues and acting in a most peculiar way. I'm just skipping his name. Not to mention scribbling incomprehensible gibberish all over his walls, as if possessed. He seemed frightened of someone and would often be found crouching in the corner of his office, moaning and thrashing when visitors came by. If he could wind up in such a beleaguered state with no warning, then perhaps so too could his son. I believe that we're looking at a curse far more powerful than anything man could devise. From the time it opened its doors to the day it closed them forever. Heavenly Host Elementary School's sealed basement room has existed as some form of cursed ground. And to find the underlying cause, we must go back beyond the infamous kidnapping and murder incident. Back a whole 20 years. I believe I may have found a clue that could shed some light on the situation. It may be a bit far-fetched as leads go, but it's a lead nonetheless. Regrettably, since Heavenly Host was not only closed down but demolished altogether and another school built in its place, it's no longer possible to investigate the basement room directly. But my protege has found what may be the next best thing. Something that could make the impossible possible once more. Preparations are being made to pursue this lead, even now. Be sure not to miss the next installment. It may be the scoop of a lifetime. Or maybe. Kokibiki, 2003, 722. Oh. Continued in Chapter 5! What a shock! So there we are. The poor beleaguered teacher was not to blame in the very slightest. It was in fact the girl in the red dress. Sachiko. Sachiko forever after.